Basically, we met on a bus.
On a bus to college, in the middle of winter.
I saw this guy under a blanket. He was fast asleep, but somehow I tripped over his foot.
Well, I used to watch it through the corner of my eye. Until then, didn't have the guts to talk to her.
You know what he said to me? He said, "So you're always tripping over me."
She had a dream. I was happy to follow her dream.
We left Delhi in 85.
And 86, May, we bought this piece of land. The cheapest land we found at that time because we were broke. But yeah, we saw the potential of the land at that time.
Felt right.
Felt right, felt good. So then and there we decided to buy it. And that's how we started.
I was 20 and he was 21. Basically, my dream was to be able to live with the land, to have control over the food that we put into our bodies. Now when I look back on it, what we've managed to do is even better than the vision that I had.
Sustainability became our main theme of our work.
Yeah, I think, yeah, it's really something that drives the whole story for us.
We did everything, like, you know, grow everything we need for our day-to-day life, make what we can't grow. You do things that make life interesting. So we went through this whole thing of making jams, jellies, pickles, clothes, soap.
The most fun parts of our life have been having our children, Kabir, Azhar, and Sukanya. And as we grew up with the land, we grew with our children.
We decided not to send our kids to school, homeschool them.
We learned so much alongside them. So our relationship with them is very different than we would have had if we had jobs in the city and we were sending them to school.
Well, the beauty of having homeschooled children is that ultimately we gave them just a few basic skills, and on top of that, they built their own abilities.
I mean, yes, Azad now, he's still searching, but he's also very interested in animal husbandry.
Yeah,
and he looks after the cattle, the cows.
And because he grew up with creatures around him, his instinctual abilities far surpasses even mine or Vivek's, in that sense that he really understands animal behavior. And where Kabir is concerned, he has another bent. They both are such total individuals on their own. One is creative with machinery and with one aspect of agriculture. The other one is actually got artistic capabilities. So how they've come together as integrated human beings is really a kind of representation of our philosophy. And we have an addition to our family now, Anjali also.
Our daughter-in-law, lucky to find a farmer girl.
Today we were packing up all our stuff for Orange County. We sent some 41 different items. You spread your risk over a wide range of activities and crops. That is what sustainability means to us.
The most interesting part of our relationship with Orange County is that we're able to continue to do the things that we do with so much joy and turn it into something that makes us economically viable.
Where does anybody now get to even taste or see wild spinach?
Yeah, so that it's been a really nice experience to share that privilege with Orange County, and that they have wanted to make that as a special part of their menu has also enabled the protection of those species.
People say, you know, I work too much. For me, it's not work because I enjoy every minute of it, you know. I don't have to work to go on holiday. You have to keep joy as one of your priorities, because if you're not getting joy out of life, what the hell are you doing?
Talking about how or what went through our heads when we decided to do this, and we were very passionate. I don't think we had any idea of the difficulties that would come. I mean, it was like you take a leap of faith and you learn to fly as you fall. When you're having fun, when you're doing something you want to do, any kind of difficulty in your path, it's not something that you feel bad about. It just makes things more interesting.
And a lot of things that we do or we don't do is because of this fear of rejection and this fear of failure. It's only when you come out of your comfort zone and you get over this fear of failure that you find the spark of life, the spice of life.